Hello everyone, I'm Louis Kamlege from the Medical Concierge Group, a digital health company headquartered in Uganda. I'm here to present our case on telemedicine and integrated last mile pharmacy and laboratory services, lessons from a private digital health company in Uganda. The background is that Uganda experiences structural and individual level barriers to universal healthcare coverage, including the low health sector investment, where only 7.5% of the GDP is invested in healthcare, which is shy of the Abuja conversion, where we recommend 15%. The lack of public health care insurance schemes and the high cost of private healthcare. Yet, 40% of healthcare expenditure is paid out of pocket, which means that the role of private health sector in healthcare delivery in Uganda remains very critical. Platforms like private healthcare insurance remain low in terms of coverage, and therefore innovations addressing the challenges of private healthcare coverage will go further in building popular demand for private healthcare and increase overall healthcare coverage in Uganda. We set out to understand Rocket Health and Indigenous Digital Health and Telemedicine Company, which has integrated telemedicine in delivering last mile medical services within private health insurance setting. While we had objectives, which included one, describing telehealth medical services delivered by Rocket Health, describing the digital technologies Rocket Health has deployed in delivering medical services in Uganda, and understanding potential facilitators and barriers to the adoption of telehealth services in private healthcare settings in Uganda. So what did we do? The period of study was between March and October 2020, where we had a couple of focus group discussions with the company director, healthcare workers, and the software engineer, where we administered open-ended questionnaires that covered details, including the technology platforms that have been deployed and how they have been used, utilized. In addition, demographic information about the end users of the telemedicine services, including age and gender, was collected from the databases of the telehealth databases that are being utilized. In addition, also anonymized electronic medical information, including medical encounters, and the cost of the medical encounters was analyzed using Excel 2020. What did we find out? We found out that Rocket Health delivers telehealth services that is faceted or modeled around a 24/7 medical call center, which is manned by health professionals via the text, voice, and video platforms. Users get to interact with these health professionals, including doctors, pharmacists, specialists, and have their health concerns resolved remotely. While there's need of a laboratory test, laboratory technician gets to be dispatched off at the client's location, sample picked up, tests done with the results disseminated via electronically and explained by the doctor. While there's need for a pharmacy prescription that has been completed, pharmacy technician gets to be dispatched off, delivers the medicines at the client's location. And also an electronic e-shop, a self-service platform, clients can log in and request for any medical service to be delivered at their location. And also where there's need for a physical consult, a physical examination, clients are scheduled for a visit at the state-of-the-art telemedicine clinic, and which is manned by nurse or clinical officer who gets to interact with the client, and then through the tele platforms, the doctor or specialists within the call center gets to perform a diagnosis remotely and offer the recommendation in terms of treatment management plan that the clinical officer will ask us to institute. The technologies that have been deployed include a voice call platform, where we have the end user calling through the predetermined or predefined number, and we'll have the doctor or specialists within the clinic, within the call center, documenting the call in the electronic medical record, and this electronic medical record system will be backed up locally and also remotely, where data can periodically be retrieved, analyzed, and trends or dashboards get to be designed to show trends and utilization of or statistics from these encounters. In addition, also, an SMS platform has been deployed, which acts in two ways. So a end user gets to either get automated reminders or responses, which could be health facility reminders, or they could be appointment reminders of the facility, reminders on taking your medicines, among others. But also a user can opt to utilize the SMS platform or text platform for teleconsultation, where you have the user sending through an inquiry via one, process flow one, and they get the doctor gets to the inquiry via process flow three, the doctor offers response via process flow four, and then the end user can have their inquiry resolved, or they can further more interact with the doctor as far as that process flow is concerned. Statistics in terms of users, their demographics and use patterns. So over the period of March to October 2020, we analyzed 3,432 encounters, for which 50% of them were females, and the majority were in the age group of 18 to 34. In terms of telehealth service use patterns, majority were teleconsultations at 40.7%, and followed by teleconsultations and pharmacy prescription at 31.8%, and then followed by teleconsultation, pharmacy and lab, which was around 16.4%. And of course, the teleconsultation and laboratory service uptake was at 11.1%. When we reviewed the medical encounters, the top five common diagnoses that were made via the teleplatforms were mainly the non-STD gastrointestinal diseases. We're talking about examples like urinary tract infections, which were around 28%, which were followed by allergic illnesses, where examples like urticaria urticaria and other allergic diseases were at 23%, and also upper airway diseases like oresia, cold, coughs were 23% respectively. Key format interviews and focus group discussions around predictors of telehealth adoption and utilization revealed that facilitators like education, revealed themes like among the facilitators where we have education and sensitization, where performing sensitization activation campaigns within prospective uptakers or utilizers of your telehealth platforms consequently drives uptake and utilization. Then also the use or the ease of use of the platforms, where there is a less learning curve in terms of the platforms deployed, facilitates uptake compared where there is need to download the application, learn how to use these applications. And then of course, user empowerment. So designing how to use guides, how to do guides, and also infographics where end users can cross-reference have been identified as potential facilitators of uptake of telehealth platforms. And then the versatility of the platforms that offer more than one channel of interaction. So we're talking about text and visual versus text only platforms are likely to be adopted by both the service providers and the end users. Then partnerships, of course, to reach greater audiences. Rocket Health, we found that Rocket Health has done it with partnerships with different entities like small and medium scale enterprises. In terms of barriers, the higher the cost of the innovation, the less likely to be adopted. Either cost in terms of setting it up or cost in terms of accessing and utilizing it. Then also the resources like network and internet connectivity are very critical to push utilization of digital platforms, because we know that digital platforms like voice and SMS require network connectivity, but also internet dependent platforms like the electronic eShop, where there's poor network connectivity, there will consequently be low uptake and utilization. And then, of course, breaking the legacy senior management. So we know that traditional healthcare is mainly brick and mortar and paper-based. So innovations that are digital often face a lot of hindrances in terms of uptake and changing model of healthcare delivery. In conclusion, we have seen that there's been an early and fast adoption of telemedicine in Uganda. And then, of course, the propriety and low cost of the telemedicine model of healthcare delivery is an opportunity for healthcare system in Uganda to leverage digital technologies in order to overcome structural barriers, like, for example, the lab doctor to patient ratio, where you can leverage a call center to reach millions of people, instead of saying, let me recruit 1,000 doctors to be in every health facility. Then, of course, the scarcity of specialist services, where, like, for example, mental health specialists, among others, who may want to leverage digital platforms to serve large audiences, not necessarily incurring costs of human resource recruitment. And then we see that telemedicine supported last mile medical service delivery, like laboratory sample pickup and pharmacy deliveries, are very important in servicing populations that are often left out in the traditional healthcare setting. For example, people with disabilities and those with chronic conditions. And of course, in terms of preference for platforms, it is not, it's important to note that platforms that are versatile in terms of channels of communication would be considered, only to be considered when you are developing or adopting telehealth supported deliveries. That's all I had for you. I implore you to read the full paper that has been published and shared, but also I look forward to your questions during the session. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.